Welcome back, dear friends. It's cold outside and I'm going to record from home today. So there is good news. Tesla supercharging times have reduced by one-third in just 5 years, the company said, as its efforts to alleviate false narratives related to elongated charging sessions have improved thanks to technological advancement. Tesla's supercharger network is already the most robust in the industry, and its tech is arguably the best out there. In terms of dependability, we seldom hear that a Tesla supercharger is out of order, and if it is, if cloud be done routine service or update. Have you ever heard that supercharger is out of order? Other EV charging companies have not been able to match the expansion or dependability of Tesla superchargers, and it's one of the key reasons consumers flock to its vehicles over competitors. Tesla revealed this morning that its supercharging times had been reduced by 30% over the past 5 years, and this is despite the mass adoption of electric vehicles over that time. The Model 3, for example, was introduced just 1 year earlier and basically triggered Tesla into hypothetical stratosphere in terms of becoming the first brand to truly offer a widely affordable and effective electric model. Of course, there were precursors before it, like the Chevrolet Bolt, for example. The Tesla defined six main reasons for the time of reduction at its supercharger. In other words, reduction in supercharging times. First, transition to V3 supercharger. Do you remember those days when Tesla was making the transition to V3? Second, efficient routing with trip planner. Third, supercharger density increasing. Fourth, vehicle efficiency. Fifth, battery preheating. And sixth, customer education. All of these six factors have helped to Tesla to speed up supercharging times. These six factors have all contributed to the reduction in supercharging times in different ways. The V3 superchargers were unveiled in 2019 and enabled charging speeds of up to 250 kilowatt or 1,000 miles of range in an hour, but only in ideal conditions. This alone has contributed to shorter wait times, but there are a variety of other factors that Tesla seems to believe were more crucial. Tesla is already moving past V3 and moving to V4, which will be even faster than the previous iteration of supercharger. The first installations are already underway in Europe and seem to support the introduction of non-Tesla electric vehicle charging with longer cables. Charging times are one of the bottlenecks of electric vehicle adoption, and this is going to solve it partially. Tesla emphasized the importance of the trip planner, which has helped cut wait times in half since 2019, the automaker said. The trip planner feature in Tesla helps drivers visit superchargers along a route that would help them get from point A to point B in the most efficient manner possible. This doesn't require elongated waits at superchargers, but relatively short stints at various charging stations that help make a drive faster and wait times less of a hassle. So it's all about how you plan your trip. Tesla has also placed a distinct focus on expanding the supercharger network over the past several years and expanded from 31,498 connectors in 2021 to 42,000 in 2022, which is 35% increase. Other tech has undoubtedly contributed to the reduction of supercharger times, but the important thing is that the micro conceptors regarding electric vehicle charging are being debunked. While it is still not a 5 or 10 minute task to charge an electric vehicle in today's age, there is also the option of home charging, which gives people the option to wake up every morning to a full charge on their electric vehicle or Tesla. This is a great advantage. So what do you think about all of these, friends? By the way, there is another good news. In another good news, Tesla Model Y continues to be a strong presence in China's NEV segment, new electric vehicle segment. Tesla's weekly insurance registrations in the domestic Chinese market may be regularly eclipsed by BYD, but a look at the electric vehicle maker's estimated sales data shows that the Model Y is making one of the biggest waves in the country's NEV sector that could be seen in the vehicle's production last month. What we have seen, data from China Passenger Car Association has showed that Tesla China sold a total of 74,402 Giga Shanghai made vehicles in February. Among this number, 51,412 were estimated to be Model Y crossovers and 22,990 were Model 3 sedans. A total of 40,479 Teslas were exported from China and 33,993 vehicles were sold locally. These sales numbers are impressive on their own, but Tesla China's February estimated production figures are pretty admirable as well. As per industry trackers, Tesla China produced 51,839 Model Y and 20,493 Model 3 in February. With this, the Model Y efficiently became China's top NEV by production volume. Following the Model Y was the BYD Yuan Plus and BYD Song Plus DMI, which saw a production of about 33,000 to 13,000 respectively. The Model Y's popularity in China is estimated to have improved following the company's round of price cuts in January. With the first quarter's exports completed, Tesla China is now expected to allocate its output to the domestic market. The results of this were hinted at China's insurance registration for the week of March 6 to March 12, while insurance registration for all passenger cars in China were down 10.6% from various week. Tesla China saw its vehicle insurance registrations improve 28.4%. That's a big number. For the week ending March 12, Tesla China saw 17,032 weekly insurance registrations, a notable improvement from the 13,266 that were estimated for the previous week. Model Y registrations were listed at 11,336 units during the week, 11% up, and there were others improvements as well. While Tesla's potential domination of the mainstream car market may be in the hands of its upcoming next generation vehicle, the highly speculated Model 2, or some call it Model C, the Model Y is already doing a very good job of showing just how prominent a mainstream electric vehicle maker from the company could be in the electric vehicle sector. Tesla CEO Elon Musk has noted in the past that the Model Y has the potential to become the auto sector's best-selling car by output. Such a goal is not far-fetched today. What do you think about all of these, friends? Now, Tesla plans to start the Model 2 affordable electric Tesla production at Gigafactory in Mexico, God willing, sometimes next year, because they should start anytime in the next month or two, the groundbreaking of Gigafactory in Mexico. And as Tom Zhu has apparently said to a local governor that he wants to break the record of construction of Gigafactory in Mexico, a record of Giga Shanghai, that means within 9 months they should start production. We'll see how it goes. This is Armin Haryan from TorqueNews.com. Give us thumbs up and subscribe to our channel, please. I would greatly appreciate it. And if you'd like to send us a thanks, we would greatly appreciate it as well, supporting our channel, and so we can continue doing what we love. God bless you. I'll look forward to your comments in the comment section below.